I am Ra and I greet you in the love and in the light of the one infinite creator. I communicate now. Question 67.1. Questioner, could you first give us the instrument's condition, please? Answer, I am Ra. The vital energies are more closely aligned with the amount of distortion normal to this entity than previous asking showed. The physical complex energy levels are somewhat less strong than at the previous asking. The psychic attack component is exceptionally strong at this particular nexus. Question 67.2. Questioner, can you describe what you call the psychic attack component and tell me why it is strong at this particular time? Answer, I am Ra. We shall elect not to retrace previously given information, but rather elect to note that the psychic attack upon this instrument is at a constant level as long as it continues in this particular service. Variations towards the distortion of intensity of attack occur due to the opportunities presented by the entity in any weakness. At this particular nexus, the entity has been dealing with the distortion which you call pain for some time, as you call this measurement, and this has a cumulatively weakening effect upon physical energy levels. This creates a particularly favorable target of opportunity, and the entity of which we have previously spoken has taken this opportunity to attempt to be of service in its own way. It is fortunate for the ongoing vitality of this contact that the instrument is a strong-willed entity with little tendency towards the distortion, called among your peoples, hysteria, since the dizzying effects of this attack have been constant and at times disruptive for several of your diurnal periods. However, this particular entity is adapting well to the situation without undue distortions towards fear. Thus the psychic attack is not successful but does have some draining influence upon the instrument. Question 67.3. Questioner, I would ask if I am correct in this analysis. We would consider that the entity making this so-called attack is offering its service with respect to its distortion in our polarized condition now so that we may more fully appreciate its polarity, and we are appreciative of the fact and thank this entity for its attempt to serve our one creator in bringing to us knowledge in, shall I say, a more complete sense. Is this correct? Answer, I am Ra. There is no correctness or incorrectness to your statement. It is an expression of a positively polarized and balanced view of negatively polarized actions which has the effect of debilitating the strength of the negatively polarized actions. Question 67.4. Questioner, we would welcome the services of the entity who uses, and I will use the misnomer attack, since I do not consider this an attack but an offering of service, and we welcome this offering of service, but we would be able, I believe, to make more full use of the services if they were not physically disabling the instrument in a minor way. For with a greater physical ability she would be able to more appreciate the service. We would greatly appreciate it if the service was carried on in some manner which we could welcome in even greater love than at present. This, I assume, would be some service that would not include the dizzying effect. I am trying to understand the mechanism of this service of the entity that seems to be constantly with us, and I am trying to understand the origin of this entity and his mechanism of greeting us. I will make a statement that will probably be incorrect but is a function of my extreme limitation in understanding the other densities and how they work. I am guessing that this particular entity is a member of the Orion Confederation and is possibly incarnate in a body of the appropriate density, which I assume is the fifth, and by mental discipline he has been able to project a portion or all of his consciousness to our coordinates, you might say, here, and it is possibly one of the seven bodies that make up his mind, body, spirit complex. Is any of this correct? And can you tell me what is correct or incorrect about this statement? Answer, I am Ra. The statement is substantially correct. Question 67.5. Questioner, would you rather not give me information as to the specifics of my statement? Answer, I am Ra. We did not perceive a query in further detail. Please re-question. Question 67.6. Questioner, which body in respect to the colors does the entity use to travel to us? Answer, I am Ra. This query is not particularly simple to answer due to the trans-dimensional nature, not only of space-time to time-space, but from density to density. the time-space light or fifth-density body is used while the space-time fifth-density body remains in fifth-density. The assumption that the consciousness is projected thereby is correct. The assumption that this conscious vehicle attached to the space-time fifth-density physical complex is that vehicle which works in this particular service is correct. Question 67.7. Questioner, I undoubtedly will ask several uninformed questions. However, I was trying to understand certain concepts that have to do with the illusion, I shall say, of polarization that seems to exist at certain density levels in the creation and how the mechanism of the interaction of consciousness works. It seems to me that the fifth density entity is attracted in some way to our group by the polarization of this group, which acts somehow as a beacon to this entity. Am I correct? Answer, I am Ra. This is, in substance, correct, but the efforts of this entity are put forward only reluctantly. The usual attempts upon positively oriented entities or groups of entities are made, as we have said, by minions of the fifth density Orion leaders, these are fourth density. The normal gambit of such fourth density attack is the tempting of the entity or group of entities away from total polarization towards service to others and toward the aggrandizement of self or of social organizations with which the self identifies. In the case of this particular group, each was given a full range of temptations to cease being of service to each other and to the one infinite creator. Each entity declined these choices and instead continued with no significant deviation from the desire for a purely other self-service orientation. At this point, one of the fifth density entities overseeing such detuning processes determined that it would be necessary to terminate the group by what you might call magical means, as you understand ritual magic. We have previously discussed the potential for the removal of one of this group by such attack and have noted that by far the most vulnerable is the instrument due to its pre-incarnative physical complex distortions. Question 67.8. Questioner, in order for this group to remain fully in service to the Creator, since we recognize this fifth density entity as the Creator, we must also attempt to serve in any way we can this entity. Is it possible for you to communicate to us the desires of this entity if there are any, in addition to us simply ceasing the reception and dissemination of that which you provide? Answer, I am Ra. This entity has two desires. The first and foremost is to, shall we say, misplace one or more of this group in a negative orientation so that it may choose to be of service along the path of service to self. The objective which must precede this is the termination of the physical complex viability of one of this group while the mind, body, spirit complex is within a controllable configuration. May we say that although we of Ra have limited understanding, it is our belief that sending this entity love and light, which each of the group is doing, is the most helpful catalyst which the group may offer to this entity. Question 67.9. Questioner, we find I am sorry. Please continue. Answer, I am Ra. We were about to note that this entity has been as neutralized as possible in our estimation by this love offering, and thus its continued presence is perhaps the understandable limit for each polarity of the various views of service which each may render to the other. Question 67.10. Questioner, we have a paradoxical situation with respect to serving the Creator. We have requests from those whom we serve in this density, for us information. However, we have requests from another density not to disseminate this information. We have portions of the Creator requesting two seemingly opposite activities of this group. It would be very helpful if we could reach the condition of full service in such a way that we were by every thought and activity serving the Creator to the very best of our ability. Is it possible for you to solve, or for the fifth density entity who offers its service to solve, this paradox which I have observed? Answer, I am Ra. It is quite possible. Question 67.11. Questioner, then how could we solve this paradox? Answer, I am Ra. Consider, if you will, that you have no ability not to serve the Creator since all is the Creator. And your individual growth patterns appear the basic third density choice. Further, they are overlaid memories of the positive polarizations of your home density. Thus your particular orientation is strongly polarized towards service to others and has attained wisdom as well as compassion. You do not have merely two opposite requests for information or lack of information from this source if you listen careful to those whose voices you may hear. This is all one voice to which you resonate upon a certain frequency. This frequency determines your choice of service to the one creator. As it happens, this group's vibratory patterns and those of Ra are compatible and enable us to speak through this instrument with your support. This is a function of free will. A portion, seemingly of the Creator, rejoices at your choice to question us regarding the evolution of spirit. A seemingly separate portion would wish for multitudinous answers to a great range of queries of a specific nature. Another seemingly separate group of your peoples would wish this correspondence through this instrument to cease, feeling it to be of a negative nature. Upon the many other planes of existence, there are those whose every fiber rejoices at your service, and those such as the entity of whom you have been speaking, which wish only to terminate the life upon the third density plane of this instrument. All are the Creator. There is one vast panoply of biases and distortions, colors and hues, in an unending pattern. In the case of those with whom you, as entities and as a group, are not in resonance, you wish them love, light, peace, joy, and bid them well. No more than this can you do for your portion of the Creator is as it is in your experience and offering of experience, to be valuable, needs be more and more a perfect representation of who you truly are. Could you, then, serve a negative entity by offering the instrument's life? It is unlikely that you would find this a true service. Thus you may see in many cases the loving balance being achieved, the love being offered, light being sent, and the service of the service to self-oriented entity gratefully acknowledged while being rejected as not being useful in your journey at this time. Thus you serve one Creator without paradox. Question 67.12. Questioner, this particular entity, by his service, is able to create a dizzying effect on the instrument. Could you describe the mechanics of such a service? Answer, I am Ra. This instrument, in the small times of its incarnation, had the distortion in the area of the otic complex of many infections which caused great difficulties at this small age, as you would call it. The scars of these distortions remain, and indeed that which you call the sinus system remains distorted. Thus the entity works with these distortions to produce a loss of the balance and a slight lack of ability to use the optic apparatus. Question 67.13. Questioner, I was wondering about the magical, shall I say, principles used by the fifth density entity giving this service and his ability to give it. Why is he able to utilize these particular physical distortions from the philosophical or magical point of view? Answer, I am Ra. This entity is able to, shall we say, penetrate in time-space configuration the field of this particular entity. It has moved through the quarantine without any vehicle and thus has been more able to escape detection by the net of the guardians. This is the great virtue of the magical working whereby consciousness is sent forth essentially without vehicle as light. The light would work instantly upon an untuned individual by suggestion, that is the stepping out in front of the traffic because the suggestion is that there is no traffic. This entity, as each in this group, is enough disciplined in the ways of love and light that it is not suggestible to any great extent. However, there is a predisposition of the physical complex which this entity is making maximal use of as regards the instrument, hoping, for instance, by means of increasing dizziness, to cause the instrument to fall or to indeed walk in front of your traffic because of impaired vision. The magical principles, shall we say, may be loosely translated into your system of magic whereby symbols are used and traced and visualized in order to develop the power of the light. Question 67.14. Questioner, do you mean then that this fifth density entity visualizes certain symbols? I am assuming that these symbols are of a nature where their continued use would have some power or charge. Am I correct? Answer, I am Ra. You are correct. In fifth density, light is as visible a tool as your pencil's writing. Question 67.15. Questioner, then am I correct in assuming that this entity configures the light into symbology, that is what we would call a physical presence? Is this correct? Answer, I am Ra. This is incorrect. The light is used to create a sufficient purity of environment for the entity to place its consciousness in a carefully created light vehicle which then uses the tools of light to do its working. The will and presence are those of the entity doing the working.